Synology MailPlus is an on-premises mail solution that ensures data ownership, security, and reliability. POP3 or IMAP protocols can be enabled in MailPlus to allow third-party email clients to access emails on the server. And with permanent and transferable MailPlus licenses, you won't have to keep renewing your subscription. Plus, you can browse your emails wherever you are with the mobile app, available on both Android and iOS. In this video, we'll show you how to install and initialize MailPlus, enable mail services for users, and configure port forwarding and DNS records. The timestamps for each section can be found in the video description. Before you start, make sure you have registered a domain and static IP. This information will be needed during setup. If you haven't registered yet, we suggest contacting a domain name provider and your internet service provider. To set up Synology MailPlus server, go to the Package Center and install Synology MailPlus and Synology MailPlus server. Launch MailPlus server and the setup wizard will appear. You can choose to create a new mail system or migrate from other mail services. We will choose Create a new mail system for this video. Set the network interface, domain name, host name, and the volume where you want to run the server and store data. Click Next. Confirm your settings, click Apply, and then wait for the initialization to complete. Next, you need to enable mail services for users by assigning MailPlus licenses. Go to the license page. You will see that there are 5 free licenses offered by Synology. If you need more licenses, you can purchase them online or contact our affiliates for more information. Purchased licenses can be found in your Synology account. If you switch to a new device in the future, you just need to re-enter your license keys to activate them. Go to the account page to activate your licenses. You can activate mail services by user or group. Tick Activate for those you want to activate mail services for. This will reduce the number of available licenses. Next, we recommend setting up port forwarding to directly access specific mail services on your NAS. For example, you need to open port 25 to exchange mails with other servers via SMTP. Go to Control Panel, External Access, to configure port forwarding rules. To learn more about port forwarding, refer to the article and video links in the description. To allow MailPlus server to exchange emails over the internet, you must register a domain name and configure the following records on a public DNS server: an MX record, mail exchanger record, which identifies mail servers for mail recipients and routes mail based on a set priority, and an A record, address record, which maps a domain to the IP address of your Synology NAS. Let's take a look at an example. When you send an email to someone@synology.com, your mail server requests the MX record to identify the receiving mail server and then uses the response to check the A record from the DNS to get the IP address of the receiving mail server. The email is then sent from your mail server to the IP address of the receiving mail server, where it is delivered to the recipient. To make sure that you've set up your DNS records correctly, you can either test them out on MX Toolbox or try sending an email to your MailPlus email account from another mail server. Now you're probably ready to set up and start using your MailPlus server. But don't go too far, we've got more in store. In the next video, we'll show you how MailPlus can help secure your company's mail system. For more on MailPlus, subscribe to the Synology YouTube channel or click on a video to keep watching.